They couldn't have been advising the wrong diet.
Dr. Peter Bruckner has spent a lifetime caring for the fittest of the fit.
I was fortunate enough to be the Australian athletics team doctor for 10 years and did the Atlanta and Sydney Olympic Games, the Socceroos, for 4 years leading up to the World Cup in South Africa in 2010. And from there, I went to the Liverpool Football Club and my most recent job was with the Australian cricket team.
But 9 years ago, Peter's own doctor delivered him a shock.
I was obese, I had pre-diabetes, I had a condition called fatty liver, I had high triglycerides, a number of metabolic abnormalities.
In the 1980s, the Australian population started gaining weight and has never looked back. Right now, 2 out of 3 adults and 1 in 4 kids are either overweight or obese. And the stats for type 2 diabetes follow the same pattern.
The official figures are about 1.2, 1.3 million people. It's thought there are another 500,000 people with undiagnosed type 2 diabetes. On top of that, there's probably another 2 million people with what we call pre-diabetes.
Maria Fraser worked in the fitness industry in the 80s and 90s, teaching aerobics, gym and weight loss classes.
I mean, I was a full-time fitness instructor teaching in the industry and still struggling with my own weight. About 2 years ago, I tipped over the 90 kilo mark. The type of advice that I was giving people back during that time was the standard dietary advice of basically a low-fat diet, high carbohydrate diet, avoiding butter, oils, your cheese, your creams, eating lots of rice, lots of pasta, lots of potatoes.
Peter Bruckner thought there was a better way to go.
So I decided to go on to a low-carb, healthy-fat diet for 3 months. So I stopped eating sugar, starches, bread, rice, pasta, potato, all the things that were pretty much staples in my diet, and replaced it with real food. So meat, fish, eggs, dairy, all the things that have been demonised for so long. Lots of green veg, nuts and seeds, olive oil, and the only fruits were berries. Well, that 3 months on that diet was life-changing. For a start, I lost 13 kilograms in 13 weeks, despite never being hungry, eating as much as I wanted. And I felt full of energy, I slept better, my blood test showed that all my metabolic abnormalities had resolved.
On a similar diet, Maria has now reversed her pre-diabetes and her back pain is gone.
So I've lost now around about 30 kilos and I did that probably over an 18-month period.
Peter Bruckner has launched a campaign to reduce sugar consumption and today he's one of 17 medical professionals behind a new app called Defeat Diabetes.
It's developed by doctors and dietitians. It's not celebrity-based, it's evidence-based. And what we really want to do is we want to give hope. You can actually put your diabetes into remission or reduce the amount of medication you're on. So we really want to create a whole community to defeat diabetes.
What a great idea. And someone else who thinks it's a great idea is the current Australian of the Year, Dr. James Newkey. James has been waging a war now on sugar for the last 12 months and he joins us now. OK, if sugar's such a problem, what do you think the government should be doing about it?
There are a number of things that the government needs to do, one of which is raising awareness of the fact that sugar is toxic and addictive, but also to raise awareness of those complications of type 2 diabetes. This is critical. Also, accountability is important here. So the government needs to hold businesses and industries who are preying on our addictions, who are using predatory sales and marketing tactics, they need to be held accountable for their tactics. And the other thing which is becoming quite apparent is that there is the opportunity to put type 2 diabetes into remission. So GPs, dietitians, nutritionists, exercise physiologists need to be given the tools and the financial help to be able to offer this solution to their patients, a really important thing that they can help their patients with.
So, Doc, I mean, I'm going to speak as somebody who loves their chocolate and understands that chocolate can be very addictive, but do you think that we should be treating sugar in the same way that we treat smoking and cigarettes?
Yeah, perhaps. And if we actually look at the big driver of type 2 diabetes being sugar in the ultra-processed foods, and we look at the fact that sugar is addictive, there is a huge amount of added sugar in our food and drink, something like 75%. And then we combine that with the fact that our world, our environment, is literally flooded with sugary products and ads for those products. So it becomes very hard to escape. So it is a danger, and it is something that we need to be aware of as a society.
James, I had burgers for dinner last night. Which part of that burger should I be most ashamed of?
Well, the best part of the burger is the meat patty. Mm-hmm. But if you've got tomato sauce, tomato ketchup in it, that's going to be high in sugar. Yep. And you also have a sweet bun made from white flour, that's also yep. going to be potentially high in sugar. So the best part of that is the cheese, the vegetables and the meat patty.
Surely the tomato and the lettuce is better for you than the meat.
Not necessarily. No, the meat, if it's unprocessed red meat as opposed to highly processed meat, then it's nutrient dense and it's healthy. In fact, natural saturated fats in meat are really critical to our health. In fact, there are no solid evidence linking these natural saturated fats we find in unprocessed red meat, also eggs, full-fat dairy, never been linked to cardiovascular disease, something that's really important to know.